surprise I have for you, Mary. It's a telephone.
A telephone?
This is a time really when we're moving from the pre-modern to the modern. We see the railroads, we're starting to see the automobiles, we're seeing the light bulb, we're seeing this novel new way of communication, namely the telephone.
Isn't it just a toy?
In 1876, Bell is already manufacturing and selling telephones. And this is very quickly making big news in Stockholm, Sweden, a country which is already fascinated by modernity and engineering. We see, you know, the birth of a totally different spirit of a time when people feel suddenly that anything and everything is possible.
And into this comes Lars Magnus Ericsson, a gifted engineer. With his wife Hilda and his business partner Carl Johan Andersson, he sets up a small workshop. Initially, he repairs and manufactures telegraph equipment. But when customers come to Ericsson with telephones to repair, he sees a terrific opportunity. Here is an invention that fascinates him. He is soon manufacturing telephones of his own design. Lars Magnus is an engineer with a vision, and his new designs capture the public's imagination. In 1883, he forms a partnership that will be the making of his company. Henrik Torre Sidergren is an entrepreneur who, like Lars Magnus, sees the potential of the telephone. The partnership's aim is to provide telephone lines in every building and for all the tenants in them at a lower price. They construct a 1,200-line gantry on the roof of the Central Exchange, able to cope with over 3,000 subscribers.
So the result of this is that by 1885, Stockholm has more telephone subscribers than any other place in the world. The telephone is now becoming an essential tool to life, not just for businesses, but also for populations separated by large expanses of water and forests.
With global demand increasing at a rapid rate, Ericsson's operations expand around the world. In Russia, China, Mexico, cables stretch out across countries, and in cities, the skies become black with cables.
I think what is really standing out in history is the globalizations early, the internationalizations, and the people, the salespeople in the early 1900s that went out on a boat and came home 2 years later and sold one product. And you think about the perseverance and the way they really internationalized Ericsson in a very early stage where aircraft or communication didn't exist over borders.
In 1903, by the time Ericsson retires, his company is one of the foremost providers of world-class telephones and telephone exchanges in the world, present in over 100 countries. This global scale would prove to be a defining asset in realizing the vision of connecting people right through to the present day.